In this video, we will begin looking at properties of exponents. Exponent notation. X raised to the power n means to multiply x n times. In our first example, we have x to the fifth. X to the fifth means we will multiply x times itself 5 times. So x to the fifth means x times x times x times x times x. 2 to the third power means 2 times 2 times 2. We can simplify this. 2 times 2 is equal to 4, and 4 times 2 is equal to 8. So 2 to the third is equal to 8. Example 3, we have negative 6 squared. Interpreting this problem is very important. You need to understand that the square is only on the number 6. It is not on the negative. We are going to square 6, 6 times 6, and we are going to bring the negative in front. So 6 times 6 is 36, and we are going to carry the negative in front. So for this problem, the answer is negative 36. Our next problem is different. In this problem, the negative 6 is in parentheses, and the square is on the outside of the parentheses. What this means to do is to multiply negative 6 times itself. So this means to write negative 6 times negative 6. Negative 6 times negative 6 is positive 36, because a negative times a negative is a positive. The product rule. When we multiply like bases, we add the exponents. So if we multiply x to the number m times x to the number n, it equals x to the m plus n. Let's see why this property works. Let's look at our first example. X to the third times x squared. We can expand this and write x to the third is x times x times x. And x squared is x times x. Notice we're multiplying 5 x's times each other. That is equal to x to the fifth. Using our rule where we add exponents of like bases when we're multiplying, we get x to the 3 plus 2. And x to the 3 plus 2 is equal to x to the fifth. Our next example, we will multiply x to the negative fifth times x to the seventh. When we multiply like bases, we add the exponents. So negative 5 plus 7, we get x to the second power. Our next example, we have coefficients in front of the x's. What we're going to do with the coefficients is multiply them because we're multiplying these two terms together. We will multiply negative 5 times 4. Negative 5 times 4 is equal to negative 20. Then we will add the exponents on the like bases, x to the 3 plus 6. So our answer is negative 20 x to the ninth. Again, we will multiply the coefficients together. Negative 2 times 6 is equal to negative 12. Then we will add exponents on like bases. So we will add 2 plus 4 to get our exponent on the x for our answer. And y has 3 and 5. We will add 3 plus 5. Negative 12 is our coefficient. 2 plus 4 is 6, so our exponent on x is 6. And 3 plus 5 is 8, so our exponent on y is 8. Our next property is the negative exponent rule. A negative exponent on a variable will move it to the denominator, and then the exponent will become positive. X to the negative n is equal to 1 over x to the positive n. Note, x cannot equal 0. Our first example, we will use our property and write it as 1 over x to the positive 2. So x to the negative 2 is equal to 1 over x to the positive 2. A to the negative 4 is equal to 1 over a to the positive 4. 6 to the negative 2 is equal to 1 over 6 squared. We can simplify this because it is a number. 6 squared is equal to 6 times 6, which is 36. So we get 1 over 36. Our next example, you need to understand that the negative is not being affected by the power on the 6. The negative will be something that is carried through the problem in front of our answer. So we have negative 1 over 6 squared. 1 over 6 squared is 36. As you can see, we just bring the negative in front of our answer. So our answer is negative 1 over 36. Our next property is the quotient rule. Quotient means to divide. When we divide like bases, we subtract exponents, the top exponent minus the bottom exponent. Note, x cannot be 0 in order to use this rule. Let's investigate why this property works. Let's expand the numerator x to the fourth as x times x times x times x. And we'll expand the denominator x to the third as x times x times x. We know that x over x is equal to 1. So we will divide out x over x, x over x, x over x. And we are left with x over 1, or just x. If we use our quotient rule, where we subtract the top exponent minus the bottom exponent, we get 4 minus 3, which is 1. A variable with a power of 1 is just the variable itself. A variable that doesn't show an exponent has an exponent of 1. So we can see how the quotient rule works. Our next example. We're going to subtract the top exponent minus the bottom exponent. We get 5 minus negative 3. We use our rules that we know for adding integers. We change subtraction to adding the opposite. We get 5 plus 3 is equal to 8. In our next example, what we want to do is look at the coefficients as a fraction that we need to simplify. We're going to look at 6 over 3 as a fraction we need to simplify. 6 over 3, or 6 divided by 3, is equal to 2. Note, in our denominator, the x variable has an exponent of 1. We will subtract our exponents, the top exponent minus the bottom exponent. So 8 minus 1 is 7. So we get 2x to the 7th. In example 4, we have coefficients that we need to simplify as a fraction. Negative 18 over 15. 18 and 15 are both divisible by 3. When we divide negative 18 by 3, we get negative 6. And when we divide 15 by 3, we get 5. Then we will subtract our exponents of our like basis. For our x's, we have an exponent of 9 in the numerator and 4 in the denominator. We will subtract 9 minus 4, the top exponent minus the bottom exponent. Notice our y's. We have y to the third over y to the third. That's going to equal the number 1. So when you divide anything by itself, it equals 1. So our simplified answer would be negative 6 over 5, x to the 9 minus 4 is equal to 5. Our next property is the power rule. When you have a power raised to another power, you multiply the powers. Let's see why this works. In our first example, we have x to the 5th raised to the 3rd. So what we're going to do is raise x to the 5th to the 3rd power by writing it, multiplying it 3 times. We could then expand the x to the fifths and write them all out in expanded form, or we can remember our multiplication rule. When we multiply like bases, we add exponents. So we get 5 plus 5 plus 5, which is equal to 15. Using the power rule, power to a power, we multiply the powers. So that would be x to the 5 times 3. X to the 5 times 3 is equal to x to the 15. We will use the power rule for our next example. We have x to the negative 2 raised to the negative 4. When we have a power to a power, we multiply the powers. So we will multiply negative 2 times negative 4. Negative 2 times negative 4 is positive 8. In this problem, we are going to use our order of operations and figure out what's inside our parentheses first. 2 squared is equal to 4. So inside the parentheses, we get 4. Then we will raise that to the third power. 4 to the third means 4 times 4 times 4. 4 times 4 is equal to 16. And 16 times 4 is equal to 64. Our next property is the zero property of exponents. If you raise any number or variable to the zero power, you get the number 1. Note, to use this rule, x cannot equal 0. So any number or variable to the zero power is equal to 1. So a to the 0 is equal to 1. 4 to the 0 is equal to 1. Notice 3xy is all in parentheses, and the power of 0 is on the outside of the parentheses. So we're raising 3xy to the 0 power. Anything raised to the 0 power is equal to 1.